now with Jerry Jones. Now, are you satisfied with him being a general manager, or should he just be an owner?
I would love for them to separate all responsibilities. That way you don't have any conflicts of interest. It's almost like politics. You have to be able to bounce things off of each other. You know, if you don't have anyone to argue against, then you have no one to check you. And they just hadn't been checked necessarily. Now, you've got a guy with the Cowboys. It's an African-American, Will McClay. Mm-hmm. He's very talented, very talented. They kind of give him free reign in regards to the players that he wants to pick. Mm-hmm. This pandemic kind of spoiled what he had going on because he really did a good job this offseason. But the pandemic just didn't mix well with the guys that he signed. Some of them got hurt, you know, COVID, all that. It just turned into a disastrous season.
Right.
He really put his foot, I mean, in a good way. He really put his foot into the recruiting of the players that he had. And it's just a shame that we didn't work out to have a better season, especially on the defensive side, because mm-hmm. that's where he concentrated most of his efforts.
Sure.
You know, with the guy Diggs, the young rookie Diggs at cornerback. We brought in Gerald McCoy, you know, from Carolina. He gets hurt in practice. He goes out with a knee, and he's out for the season, and we had to cut him. Wow. So it just kind of buzzer luck thing for the Cowboys this season. But I think as long as they hand things over to Will McClay, they'll be in better shape than they would be by just having Jerry making the decisions.
Let's go back to the 80s, man. Playing for the Cowboys, man. What was that like, man? Me being a Giants fan, the hole in the
we can get to you later then. That's good.
Yeah, because you was on the team, yeah. Right. And I remember you were the oldest Anderson team, right?
Well, we were on each other's team.
Right? Well, he was on each other's team, but he was the MVP of the Super Bowl that year, right?
Yes, he was. This is a barbershop talk. Yeah.
You were, you had two of the greatest running backs in college football history. Tony Dorsett and Herschel Walker was on.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Yeah, were your teammates, man. And what was the culture like?
Well, there was a big gap between when Tony got there and when Herschel got there. I got mostly Tony Dorsett, and I tell people all the time, that was my Michael Jordan. You know, he was my LeBron James. You know, I just watched him. I don't know, you know, I can't tell how big you are, you know, just from what I see.
I'm 5'7".
Well, Dorsett was maybe. Uh-huh. He was tiptoe when they would do his height, and he would try to somehow bend the scale when he was stepping for weight. He was about 5'8".
What?
He was about 5'8".
What?
Maybe 5'9". I give him 5'9" to be generous, and he was probably, he started lifting weights. I'd give him 190. Wow. Maybe 190. Be tough to give him 190. He wore every pad that's issued to man. Wow. Because he had to. He was one of the quickest from 0 to 60 that you've ever seen in your life. That's what made him so amazing. He outran angles way before anybody that you've ever seen. The only person that I know may have been faster in the NFL was the one that caught him, and that was Darryl Green. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, you're just looking at a guy who you just wouldn't believe the punishment that he took. Mm. Because, you know, when you're with the Cowboys, you're the running back. That's like being the quarterback of the Cowboys these days. Mm. The running back position was just prime. That was the position. Dorsett was the darling of the NFL, and especially of the Dallas Cowboys, which, when you're America's team, that goes a long way.
Sure.
Linebackers from the Giants, Carson, your boy, Hunt, Bang.
Yeah, you caught the tail end of them. They got a championship, man. Stay with pride.
Dude, hey, those brothers, when they would catch up with Dorsett, he wouldn't run out of bounds. He had heart. He had heart. That's just where they were. They didn't run out of bounds. Uh-huh. And so he would stay. He would go down that sideline, mm-hmm. and he's going full speed, and they have the angle on him. And it seemed like three people would just hit him at once. Mm-hmm. And they would just power drive his little butt, right? I mean, because he was so small. Mm-hmm. And they would, you know how brothers are when they land on you.
Yeah, yeah.
They don't just, you know, they outlawed that, actually. That's how bad it was. I mean, all three of them were just like, you know, just like pressing machine.
Wow.
And he would be the last one to get up. He would get up like he was Fred Sanford. It would take his time. He'd lift up his pants, and he would walk back to the huddle. They give him the ball again, and he's so fast you might not see it. He had more heart than people ever gave him credit for. Tough guy.
How were the one-on-ones with you and Drew? How was that in one-on-ones?
Oh my God.
I played in college, so I understand the one-on-one drill. Oh, I understand we hated each other, and then we went to the I didn't play professional, I played in college. So we went to the CI and we talked a whole lot of shit. You know what I mean? But you and Drew, those battles.